And it's that sort of, that real awakening that everyone has that really attracted me to the part, because it was so in this film. It happens in this film. It's not a film about someone who's naive all the way through the film, or someone who's naive, later in life. It's about this kid who has this change slap bang in the middle of this story. So that's what really attracted me to it. The essence of Paul's character is the fact that he is always hiding from something, and you know, he hides from the fact that he's been used and being used even still, and then he finds it very hard to relate to his mother, and finds it very hard to show his feelings towards Richard Kennington, and then when he does, he really does, and then he makes the mistake of opening up too much and then becomes wounded. The first day was nice. It was a very easy day, but I came onto set and it was all very kind of, the cinema side of it was magnificent. You know, we had these great shots and these massive cranes, and I remember seeing them back on the video and saw them back, and I thought, oh yeah, that's good. That'll do. So that was really when I started to get excited. On the first day, I really started to get excited about this film. Before I made this film, I hadn't heard of Ventura, but I was working here in Barcelona when I got the script, and I asked some people here in Barcelona, and I said, look, I'm going for this film in Barcelona, I could be back here again, you know, who is this Ventura Pons guy? And they were, oh, Ventura Pons is Spain, he is marvellous, magnificent. And I said, oh right, oh that's very good, you know. But it was bad, because I was just about to go into my audition, so I then became incredibly nervous, and meeting this sort of Spanish film guru in this small little room. But he was, when I met him, he was very very polite, and said, and very fair, and he said, very complimentary as well. He said, you know, you did a very good performance there, well done, which is rare in an audition. It's usually very sort of like, dum dum bum, move on. And he said, well done, I was very pleased with you then. And then I came back, having got the part, I'd seen Anita, No Pierder Tron, and I really enjoyed that film. I think that the people who are fans of Ventura's work will probably be a bit surprised on the way that this sex and the love scenes have been portrayed in this film, because there's no aggression in the sex. You know, it's sex, but it's a very kind of it's very intimate. It's mostly intimacy and a real portrayal of love, which is hard to sort of find in a sex scene. Very rarely do you ever watch a sex scene and you see that the people who are doing the scene are actually having some kind of chemistry, which I think in this film there's definitely a very strong chemistry between Paul and I and Alan and I, because we're all mates, and second because they're both very good actors as well. So the sex scenes are very subtle, but they're very real as well, I think. Yeah, and it's not sordid and hard. It's not about a hard gay, relationship. I mean, this story is about relationships, and basically it could be. A relationship between two heterosexual people, you know, it's just the same. It's just exactly the same. It could be between a bisexual person, lesbian, homosexual, heterosexual, anyone. It's really about the relationship and the stuff that goes on other than the sex. That's why I did it. Working in Barcelona, well, this is the second time I've worked in Barcelona. And I'd never worked in Barcelona before this year. So it's the second time in 1 year, which is really strange. And it's just by pure coincidence. But working in Barcelona has really been one of the best, well now two of the best experiences I've had, because it's so relaxed here. We work a very steady, a very fast week, and we get a lot done, and and it's very family orientated here amongst the set. Everyone's very, very close. You know, there's no kind of on set petty quarrels, which is so common in England. You know, see it all the time, but here it's just. I'm enjoying very much working in Spain, and I'd love to work here again.